Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Before watching this video, we suggest that you first view the video on plate tectonics. As humans, it's in our nature to admire the beauty around us and ask how it was made. Geology is the branch of the earth sciences which seeks to answer many questions about the earth, including how rocks were made and how they arrived at their current locations. This is the first of a three-part series on rock types. In this video, we will list the three basic rock types, define and give examples of common igneous rocks, describe how igneous rocks are made and how they got to where they are now. Although there are many specific types of rocks that naturally form on Earth, geologists group these into one of three types: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. This video will focus on igneous rocks, and we'll look at four common examples: pumice, scoria, basalt, and granite. The word igneous shares a common root with the words ignition and ignite, all of which refer to a fire. We call these igneous rocks because they come from the hot layers deep below the Earth's surface, which are even hotter than a fire. Volcanoes can create three of the four rock types we'll discuss. The first one is called pumice. You may have heard of this as a common product some people use to scrub things with. When we look closely, we can see a lot of tiny holes. Those holes were likely filled with tiny gas bubbles that got trapped as the liquid lava cooled down very quickly from liquid lava to a solid rock. This is similar to how tiny bubbles of air get trapped in liquid water that quickly freezes to solid ice. Pumice is often made by volcanoes that eject lava very high. The lava that shoots out far from a volcano may have a particular chemistry that, when combined with cooling down very fast, can turn that lava into pumice. Unlike other common rocks, such as granite and scoria, pumice has so many tiny holes inside it that are filled with air that pumice can float on water. Pumice has a low density, so feels like styrofoam. The next igneous rock is called scoria, sometimes called lava rocks. It also has tiny holes where bubbles of gas were trapped. You may have seen this as a filler around trees or the edges of buildings. Like pumice, scoria is also formed from lava, but it takes a little longer to cool down than pumice does. This rock may be made at the surface of lava flows. Basalt is the most common igneous rock that cools relatively quickly. Although it may take longer to cool than pumice and scoria, almost all lava from a volcano cools to become basalt. This can form from fast-moving lava that is below the surface of the lava river, so takes longer to cool down since it's not in direct contact with the cool air. Because it takes longer to cool down, the bubbles have time to escape before the liquid lava turns to solid rock. Basalt stones are often polished, so they look like this, and can be used for decoration, and sometimes people warm them up and put them on a sore muscle. Basalt is also the rock that makes up the oceanic crust, and can be made from the lava of underwater volcanoes. If thick layers of lava cool a bit more slowly, then the basalt that lava becomes may shrink a little in the process and make columns like these. If the lava cools moderately slowly, the columns become narrow. If the lava cools even slower, the columns get wider. Pumice, scoria, and basalt are made from lava that comes from volcanoes. Since all three of these igneous rocks come from volcanoes and are cooled relatively quickly by either the air or water, we call them extrusive igneous rocks. The word extrude means to push something out. It sounds similar to exit. Geologists use the word to mean that the magma exited the Earth's crust quickly. The last igneous rock example we'll introduce is granite. Granite is very strong and was once a favorite material for making tall buildings like this lighthouse. In nature, granite looks like the rocks around the lighthouse, but it can also be found inland. For example, Midwestern states have a lot of granite. Nowadays, granite is fairly popular for making kitchen countertops like this. If we get closer, you can see groups of colors. In this case, black, gray, light brown, and white. There are many different types of granite, so the colors vary. You may have seen small granite stones around sidewalks that were made by crushing larger rocks. When we look inside, we also see groups of colors, mostly gray, but with some white that sparkle. The clue to know how granite is made is in the color groups. What do you think those groups represent? Those color groups are large crystals. The white ones are quartz. Instead of having the shape of this large quartz crystal, the quartz filled in only the available spaces between the light brown crystals. The light brown crystals are feldspar. You may recognize these from the Mohs hardness scale. Crystals form when the liquid state of a pure substance slowly turns into the solid state. This is rock candy, which is large crystals of sugar. It's made by dissolving sugar in hot water, then waiting for the water to evaporate over several days. The large crystals tell us that the granite was made from liquid rock that cooled slowly. To better understand this, let's review a little bit about the Earth's interior that we learned in the plate tectonics video. The crust is the outermost layer of the Earth and is typically less than 60 miles thick. Below the crust is a layer called the mantle. The mantle is very hot, and it is solid rock. When there is a small crack in the crust, some of the mantle turns into the liquid state, which we then call magma. If that magma reaches a volcano and exits the volcano, then we change its name from magma to lava. On the other hand, if that magma never exits the crust and is instead trapped inside the crust for thousands or even millions of years, it will cool very slowly and form large crystals, such as those we see in granite. Unlike extrusive igneous rocks that exit the Earth's crust quickly through a volcano, the magma that becomes granite stays inside the Earth's crust for a long time. Geologists call granite an example of an intrusive igneous rock because it stays inside the crust for a long time. Magma collections are often more than a mile below the Earth's surface, so it may seem puzzling that we can see intrusive rocks like granite above the dirt. Let's use this simple drawing to understand the explanation. First, liquid magma flows up from the mantle through a crack in the crust and collects in a shape we call an igneous intrusion. Over thousands or even millions of years, that liquid magma slowly cools to form solid igneous intrusive rocks, such as granite. Then the more time, the thick crust that was over that intrusion is worn away by erosion and weathering, such as by glaciers, rivers, and the wind. Once the overlying dirt and other rocks are gone, we see the igneous intrusion. Here's an example of what we just saw in the drawing. These rocks are igneous intrusions made of granite. All of these rocks were once liquid magma inside igneous intrusions more than a mile under the surface. It took many thousands of years or even longer for the liquid magma to cool and in the process change from liquid to a solid rock. As the liquid magma cooled, and for an even longer period of time after that, this part of the world was having its top layers of rock and dirt removed by erosion and weathering. Until finally, the granite rocks have been exposed as we see them now. Here's a summary of this video. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.